If you've been watching this channel for a while, you've seen these videos here where we upgraded the electrical systems in OEM RVs that already had their, you know, factory electrical system. And during this process, we did a battery bank relocation kit, which basically meant that we removed the factory 12 volt batteries and then rewired the old battery bank with the new battery bank. And so the new battery bank was directly powering all 12 volt loads. And, you know, this sort of, over time, you know, 1,000+ systems that we've sort of helped with over the years, we've determined that that's really not the best, the best way to do things. There's a simpler way, an easier way, and a way that sort of takes any questions out of the equations. Specifically in regards to OEM 12 volt loads like jacks, slides, pre-existing 12 volt air conditioners, trailer brakes was another one. And so this video, I'm just going to explain sort of how the pre-existing OEM electrical system of a camper or RV works, and what our current methods are to actually sort of approach making these upgrades. So let's start with the basics. How does the typical stock OEM RV, how is it wired, and sort of how is the flow of power going through the RV? So here's a rough diagram of sort of how that looks at the base level. And so we're just going to go through this sort of step by step. So over here on the left-hand side is shore power and the built-in generator. Shore power and built-in generator, it's flowing 120 volt AC power, and there would be a transfer switch right here that really sort of doesn't matter. All that we really need to know is that 120 volt AC power is going into the 120 volt AC breaker box. So from there, that is going to be powering all of the 120 volt AC outlets, the air conditioner, anything that requires just standard household power around the camper. It's coming directly from the AC breaker box powered from the shore power and generator. For all the DC loads, behind the AC breaker box is going to be a converter that takes 120 volt AC power and converts it to 12 volt DC power. And then it sends it to the factory 12 volt battery for all the house loads. Now, all the house loads are then connected to the battery. So whether that's slide outs, jacks, trailer brakes, if there's jump starting in a motorhome, or if there's 7-pin charging from a towable vehicle, all that's pretty much connected right to the battery. There's also going to be a 12 volt fuse panel connected to the battery that's going to power small things like lights, fans, you know, 12 volt refrigerator if it's got it, that kind of thing. If there's any kind of like OEM DC charging, so factory solar or 7-pin charging like I just talked about, it's also going to be in that same realm. But realistically, it's all connected to the 12 volt battery. That's the main takeaway from here. All 12 volt loads, all 12 volt chargers from the factory are connected to that factory 12 volt battery. Now, if we have a factory inverter in play here, here's how the flow of power sort of changes. Same thing on this side, nothing changes from shore power or generator to the 120 volt AC breaker box. Nothing changes from the converter out this direction from the battery to the DC loads. What does change off the back of the AC breaker box, instead of going directly to the 120 volt AC outlets, air conditioner, stuff like that, there's a transfer switch that's typically inside of the inverter. And if shore power is available, if there is power coming to this breaker box here, then that power is coming here. That transfer switch is saying, hey, we're connected to shore power. I'm just going to let this power just pass right through, and then it's going to power all the 120 volt outlets and the air conditioner that's on this circuit. Now, if there's not shore power available, if this goes away, then the power is being pulled from the battery. So 12 volt DC power to 120 volt AC power, which is the whole purpose of the inverter. Now, the sort of the bad part about how this is wired from the factory is typically your inverter is only on one AC circuit up here. So you probably, honestly, the air conditioner is probably not going to be up here. The air conditioner is probably going to be off of a secondary circuit that's right off of the breaker box. and your factory inverter is generally not going to be able to, I mean, it's not even going to be connected to the air conditioner, so it's not even going to have a chance to power it. The other sort of negative there is that this inverter is really only going to power one circuit worth of outlets. It might be the refrigerator circuit. You might actually not have any 120 volt outlets available for your use unless you're connected to shore power. Now, these are a bunch of generalizations because not every RV is wired the exact same, but this is in general mostly how RVs with built-in inverters are wired. With Explorist Life Systems, this is the way that we've done it in the past. All those videos that I talked about at the start of this video that we've released the tutorials on that had a battery bank relocation kit in them, this is how it worked. We would splice into this wire that went in between the generator, the shore power pedestal, and the 120 volt AC breaker box. It would go into our inverter charger right here. It would take power and it would charge the brand new battery bank down here. And then it would take that battery power, and then that battery power would be charged by a secondary circuit to the alternator and a secondary circuit to solar, to usually upgraded solar, upgraded alternator charging in this regard. And the batteries down here, they would then go back out this way and then feed the entire 120 volt AC breaker panel. Now we're going to ignore the 12 volt DC side of things for a second, because this is just explaining how it's always been, and there's some similarities to how it's always been. We're not rechanging everything. So from the inverter function of the multi-plus inverter charger here, it's going out to feed the entire 120 volt AC breaker box there, which is then going to feed the 120 volt AC outlets, air conditioner, whatever else is powered from that 120 volt AC breaker box. Now in the past, we've just left the factory inverter in place, and that's going to continue to be that way. We're always going to leave that factory inverter in place, just because now this transfer switch that's inside the inverter, it's always going to see 120 volt AC power on this line here, regardless of if it's coming from the generator, regardless of if it's coming from shore power, regardless of if it's coming from the multi-plus through our brand new upgraded lithium battery bank down there. The transfer switch, it doesn't care what is supplying that 120 volt power. It just knows that it's being supplied 120 volt power. So that's just going to stay in place. We could remove it, but why? There's really no reason. It's just added work for really no extra benefit. The old way that we would do these systems with the battery bank relocation kit is we would remove the factory battery. You know, if you'll recall that the factory battery was here in place with a converter, that is right here. We would replace that factory battery with just bus bars, and then we would wire that to our brand new battery bank so that the new battery bank was directly powering the old battery location. And doing that, we would remove the 120 volt AC to 12 volt DC converter, because realistically the multi-plus was taking care of that. If we didn't do this, then the multi-plus would be powering the breaker box would be powering the converter would be trying to recharge these batteries, which would be powering the inverter, which would be powering the breaker box. There's an inefficiency loop going on there. Turning off the converter fixed that problem. So the problem with doing it like this that a lot of our viewers actually brought up was, what happens with trailer brakes? What happens with a lithium battery if it gets too low? What happens if there's something wrong with the BMS? Trailer brakes may stop working. And although I think that's an extremely rare case that something like that happens, because if a lead acid battery from the factory, if this battery is low or is damaged, well, the trailer brakes still aren't going to work. So, I mean, if we can't power them from the factory battery, you know, I don't know if that's going to make a big deal, but it was a concern that a lot of people brought up, and the new way sort of fixes this. The other problem with this is we found that through our installation program, you know, our in-house installation team, we found that there was a lot of people that were doing a lot of modifications down on this side, doing a lot of really weird stuff to the electrical system, and we didn't want to touch it anymore, because we found that the less we could touch the factory electrical system and whatever modifications were happening over on this side, If somebody brought our installation team a camper that was working, with all loads were working, all their 12-volt loads and air conditioners and incinerator toilets or whatever they've added to their camper, if they were all working when they brought them to us, they were all going to work when they left from us, because we were the only spot that we were going to touch is where that multi-bless is. We're going to splice into this wire between the generator and the breaker box right there at the transfer switch, and that power is just going to go right to the multi-bless. So with the 12 volt well, this should have been 24 and 48 volt systems, but you get the picture here. So with 24 and 48 volt systems, we had another problem that the battery bank relocation kit honestly didn't fix. And I know if you've installed this system, you know, maybe you ran into it, but with the brand new battery bank, we would actually have to leave the factory battery in place. And then we would put a 24 to 12 volt converter in line right here, or if this is a 48 volt system, a 48 volt to 12 volt converter, and feed this factory battery right here, because we found that, you know, if we have a 70 amp converter right here and we remove that battery and you've got slide outs and jacks and you're trying to run them both at the same time, this converter might not be able to keep up. And we had quite a few customers who were like, well, can I just add another converter? And I mean, yeah, I guess so. I guess you could throw as many converters at the problem as you really like. And I'm happy to sell them to you, but I'm also looking for solutions that are a little more realistic, that don't really require, you know, a whole lot of extra redundancies and stuff like that for no real reason. So we came up with the new way. So the new way totally gets rid of the battery bank relocation kit. It doesn't touch anything from this side of the system down. You do have to leave this in place, but no matter what was here from the factory is going to remain here, and it's going to continue to work. The only thing that we're touching here is at, you know, past the transfer switch where the generator comes in and the shore power pedestal comes in. We're sending that to the multi-plus, just the same as it's always been. And then we're just going to have our secondary battery bank just the way it's always been. That's being recharged by upgraded alternator charging. That's being recharged by solar charging. That's being recharged from built-in generator or shore power. Nothing changes in that regard. We're just no longer connecting to the factory 12 volt system. So how does the factory 12 volt system, you know, keep working? Well, the same way as it always does. When you buy that system from the factory, our 120 volt AC breaker box is going to the 120 volt to 12 volt DC converter that's installed from the factory to power the battery, to power all those other loads. With the new way of doing these systems, that same thing is happening. It's just being powered from the built-in generator, it's being powered from the shore power pedestal, or it's being powered from that brand new battery bank. And that's the best way that we can come up with doing this. And by doing this, it also allows us to do 12 volt systems, 24 volt systems, 48 volt systems with realistically no other considerations. If somebody really wants a 48 volt system, there is no problem there with just dropping a 48 volt system in right here, because this side of the system doesn't know what voltage this side of the system is down here, nor does it care. All it knows is that it's sending power from shore power or generator to the multi-plus for shore power recharging or generator recharging, and then all the conversions and the storage is happening down here and feeding the 120 volt AC breaker box just the same as it would have been from shore power. This factory battery is going to stay in place, and it's going to think that it's always being charged from shore power, because it sort of kind of is, with the multi-plus always supplying power to this. Now, do you have to leave your factory 12 volt lead acid battery in place? Yeah, you do, but it's just sort of how this works, and it's going to work the best and keep everything the same as factory. I know some people are going to ask, well, can I upgrade this to lithium? It's, well, yeah, I guess you might be able to, but you know, then if you have BMS issues that with your trailer brakes, then that's not going to work. And you know, it's one of those things, it's like, but why? I mean, I'm happy to sell you another lithium battery, but I just have to, you know, go on the record here and saying that I don't think it's really worth it, because since this is staying connected to shore power, quote unquote shore power, regardless of which charging system it's being powered by, you know, that's just going to stay charged all the time in that lead acid battery. It's going to last for years and years and years because you're really not using it to its full depth ever. So this is the old way versus the new way of how we're doing things in our store. We've already sort of been doing this for probably 8 months at this point before we made this video. I just was sort of testing it to make sure that this is the way we really like doing it. And this is the only way that we will install a system at our in-house installation shop. Shameless plug for that, because of, you know, how easy and seamless this makes it. And, you know, if we're having to charge for labor, you know, well, we want to keep this stuff as cost effective for all of y'all as possible. So this is the way we're going to do things going forward. We're still going to leave the battery bank relocation kits on our site because I know some of y'all are sort of bound and determined to get rid of that lead acid battery. And that's fine. If you want to buy a battery bank relocation kit and get rid of that, I'm happy to sell it to you. But I just don't think that it's the best way to do things anymore. Now, for all of you who have installed systems with a battery bank relocation kit, am I recommending that you tear it out? No, I'm not. I don't think it's that big a deal to warrant, you know, ripping out systems that are working just fine. If everything is working perfectly, I'm not going to recommend tearing it out. I know the motorhome that we installed for my mom, it has a battery bank relocation kit in it, and I am not going to tear that out because it's working perfectly wonderfully, and we're having no problems with it. So it's going to stay in place. I'm not worried about any kind of safety concerns, anything like that. Performance is still incredible on that thing. So that's the old way. In the new way, I hope this provides a little bit of clarity into the way that we're doing things nowadays on shop.explorist.life for all of our systems purchased through there. Really excited that it gives us a nice, easy, seamless way to do 12 volt, 24 volt, and 48 volt systems down on this end. If you're in the market for a system that can upgrade the electrical capabilities of your motorhome or RV, hit us up at shop.explorist.life/support, and our customer support team would love to help you out and get you a system that'll give you all those functionalities that you want at a way that is easy and pain-free to install. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.